Yo, it's Big Ant, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in on St. Louis rapper 30 Deep Grimeyy, man. Arrested on illegal and unlawful possession of a firearm. Now, if you don't know, 30 Deep Grimeyy is from St. Louis, man. And he has spoken before about having a criminal background, going to prison and serving time before. He is a self-admitted on his own and spoke on being a Crip from St. Louis. And if you don't know about St. Louis, gangs and everything like that, it's very serious out there. Very, very real. I'm talking about territory, block for block, street for street, hood by hood. The program and the politics of St. Louis is very, very serious. It doesn't get a lot of coverage in hip hop because there's not a whole lot of rappers that have made it out of St. Louis, but do understand St. Louis is a very, very dangerous place. You can look at the crime and murder right there. Small city, but it go real crazy. So this is the reason why artists like 30 Deep Grimeyy still keep guns on them. He's not a super duper mainstream artist yet, but he's on the come up. You know, I got hip to him. I had seen a couple of his videos online before, but really got hip to him when Say Cheese did the interview with him last year. And this is where this information actually came from, that he did get booked on the unlawful possession of a firearm. And him being a felon, that could go either way, dog. So more details will come out on this situation, and I'll speak up on those if anything drastic changes or I don't see it getting put online all over the place or not. But he was arrested, according to Say Cheese and everything like that, on their platform. And this is a tough situation. I want to put this picture out there for people, because niggas going to always say, hey, man, you should have had security, or you got to be moving right, bro. That shit is so much easier said than done. A lot of people say that shit, but it don't work like that at all times, bro. This shit is part of the game, especially when you coming from the streets. Some artist's street story, their street background, is why the reason they are partially a successful rapper, because they can talk about these things and put these things in their music that, you know, hey, this is my real life. This is how I'm really living. Their story can sell. You know, 30 Deep Grimeyy got a lot of respect for being a street nigga, being a gangster and everything like that, but also having a motherfucking job. And then, you know, when the music is good and he can put out good songs, that sells it even more. So it's a part of the brand, but nigga can't really erase their past. And when you still moving around trying to come up and you ain't the $30 million a year rapper yet, or the $20 million a year rapper, you can't really move around with top-notch security to feel protected enough. Yeah, you can have a couple of your homeboys. You might be able to hire one bodyguard, but shit, you gonna still feel like, hey, nigga, I gotta have a blower on me too. And that's just coming from me seeing how shit work, bro, and just knowing to be like a real human and how, nigga, it's like, hold on, dog. It's motherfucking street shit that come with me, and part of this shit is me being a rapper. I can't just be out here moving with no motherfucking protection. So when these rappers get caught up with guns, like we just had the baby, and other rappers get caught up with guns recently, it's just part of this shit, bro. So a nigga not saying niggas is moving stupid, because this nigga here is still on the come up, and there's too many motherfucking rappers dying out here over crazy shit, robberies, opposite, you know, street shit, the opposite side. And then, you know, some niggas just be in the wrong place at the wrong time, bro. You just never know. So we just got to wait and see what happened. We'll see what's going on with it. 2021 starting out real fucking fucked up, looking like 2021. Damn near trying to head in the direction of 2020. Had the shit go down at the Capitol building. Just seen the baby get arrested in LA for a gun. Just seen Rio the Young OG out of Flint, Michigan get sentenced to 5 years. He's also one of the hottest motherfucking underground rappers. So, man, I'm hoping 2021 can really turn a shift, but it's looking real wicked right now, man. Hit the comment section, like, dislike, however you feel. Tell me what y'all think about this shit. Shout out to motherfucking St. Louis too, man. I'm looking forward to seeing more artists come out of St. Louis, man. RP my nigga Boobot, real St. Louis nigga for shit show. Love you, boy. And motherfucking subscribe to the channel, man. 1,000 for shit show.